And there are researchers says that up to 3 days or 4 days or 7 days even, a person can live without taking even a drop of liquid, without taking water or anything. But everybody will be agreed with me, you can just immediately test it, you can hold your nose tight and lips closed, you can test yourself how long you can remain without taking the air. This is very important. This you can test, very simple. Close your mouth and close your both the nostrils. How long you are going to? But we do not know the importance of the breath. Maybe, depending on the practice of the person, he may hold his breath for a few minutes, not more than that. Not more than that. The breath comes and goes because the air is free. Nobody knows how it goes, how it comes out. The breathing is free. Breathing is one of the important parts. Second important thing, mind. What's mind? Where is the mind? There are a lot of theories about the mind. We are not discussing, we don't have time also. But somewhere, the thought process, what we think, what type of thoughts we get, or what we wanted to do, how we wanted to do, it is being controlled by an unknown part which is not physically present, where it is present, in what form it is present, nobody knows. There are theories which we call it as mind. Which we call it as mind. This is the second component, second important component. And the third important component is the body. So the breath, mind and body, when all the three does its function on its own perfectly, I think he will be the ideal individual to be defined like. But it's not happening. It's not happening in most of us. Somewhere we fail to take proper breathing. Somewhere we are not able to control our own mind. That's what our elders say, that when they defined about the mind, no definition was suitable or no theory was suitable, with only one word they defined, mind is a monkey. Manamuru kurangu. Which can jump from location to location, place to place, or anywhere to anywhere. Without any permission or without any mode of transport, that is the peace of the future. See, it can go anywhere without any permission, without any mode of transport, without any cost. There is no cost involved. The finest part of it. So mind was defined by our elders like mind is a monkey. Body. So what we do it to this body? You have to nurture this holy gift given to you. How you are nurturing? See, we don't nurture the body as a whole, thinking about that internal organs. How we nurture? We go to a barber, we take our proper haircut, dyeing, all those things. We made our hair all that we think is one part before. We can go for a good shave or anything like that. Go to a beauty barber, take different type of things. Then you take a facial or this or that, and you go, you thought that, okay, I have done something for. And we are wearing different type of clothes, and we select the clothes, we spend a lot of time to select the clothes, we spend a lot of money to take the clothes. within the dress, they honor the body with the cloth. And finally, we all feel how we nurture the body means, yes, I take this food, I take that food, I am eating this, I am eating that, I am taking nutritious food, juice, this, we will define. We will list out number of foods. But we take a lot of food without knowing what are the impacts of those food ingredients on the different parts of the body which are not seen by us. Have you ever seen your pancreas? Have you ever seen your liver? Have you ever seen your heart? We don't understand what are the types of troubles those organs undergo when you take different type of. But we bother about only one thing. What is it? People say, as this is nutritious, that is nutritious, they will give, Nestle will make an advertisement and you will find out this, that, this is important, that is important, the colorful advertisement, that is one part of it. Second part of it is the tongue. Tongue is bothered only about the taste. So once you feel satisfied, you feel, anybody feel, anything, you can sit comfortably. Take a chair and sit comfortably, no problem. So you feel, once you fit the body with the proper, this thing, yes, I have taken very good ice cream today, you feel satisfied. You have taken this type of food or that type of food, a particular food. And what you did was you satisfied the simple egoistic request of the tongue, nothing else. You have satisfied the egoistic request of the tongue, nothing else. But whatever the things you just drop inside, whatever it goes inside, you know what are the problems faced by the inner organs. So that we need to take care as we are all educated people. The next part, the exercises. What do you think? Yes, I have taken a lot of food, that means I have taken care of my body. No. Your cells and tissues need to be nurtured, need to be taught what it is supposed to do. If there is a joint, if the joint can move 90 degree, you should be able to move the joint 90 degree. How is it possible? No, I will keep the joint straight all along and one day I wanted to move the joint 90 degree. It will not okay. Because the particular cell or the particular tissue or the particular part of the joint do not know how to bend. Because you never taught. You never said to it, yes, you have to bend. You never asked that muscle to bend. You never asked that joint to move. Then one fine day, yeah, I am supposed to do some other work, I am moving and it is not listening to me. It will not be. So the only way is, we have to tell the different muscles, tissues, joints, hey, Baba, you have to move. These are the ways you are supposed to move. For this only, these joints and these type of all different type of tissues were given to us by the Lord. This we have to make them understand. For that, only thing possible is exercise. Only thing possible is exercise. Different type of exercises are there. You can go for anything. Do it. But as madam said, the union, yoga is the one where it can join all these three. Your breath, your mind, your body. See, your mind keep on jumps. Just you close your eyes and look into the air which goes inside your lungs and how it comes out. Just observe that alone, automatically your mind will come. Most of the time we try to control our mind by saying something or by compulsion. But by compulsion the mind cannot be controlled. Only by looking at your breath, watching your breath. For that we must know how to breathe. We have to enhance our lung capacity. The research very clearly says that most of the people in the world, they use only the 30-35% of the lung capacity. They don't use more than that. And you know how volumetric air we are taking. And another important part, you know how this, whatever the wastage is created in the body, it is being released out. We simply think that by urine and motion or all the sweating, all these three things will be removed. Only 10% of all these toxins generated in the body will be released through the urine, motion and sweating. Nearly 90% of the toxins are being released out by your breath. Please go on searching your book. 5 hours. Then you will understand the importance of the breathing. How deep you take the breath. How you feel your lungs. That needs to be practiced. So the yoga is union of this breath, mind and the body. And if you do the simple exercise of control, you will tell the different joints and the muscles and the tissues, yes, the body, you have to bend, you have to move, you have to listen. But we don't do anything and we expect that the body should listen to me. Body should do whatever I have command. The day you wanted to walk 2 kilometers more, the day you wanted to do some more work, the day you have a function at home, you are doing a lot of things and you feel the pain. So definitely it will happen. So my humble request to all my friends and colleagues, please do something for the body which has been given as a holy gift from the body. Do something for that. It is up to you how you are going to manage. Most of the time, the only thing what they say, I don't have time. I don't have time. When you don't have time to nurture your body, then later on we will find lot of time to sit in queues in the hospital, lie down in the hospital. This is happening. This is happening. This is truth. I don't know how many of you noticed that yesterday there was an article from Tripur. There is a couple, one Mr. Balasubramanian and one Mr. They have not visited 16 years to the hospital. 16 years. You know what is his age? 82 plus the doctor. 18 plus. So 16 years he is telling means he is talking about the age after 60. Age after 60. After 60 a person is living healthier, he is doing all his work, he is working, he is doing everything, they are looking on their own and they are living a happy life means this is something great. Otherwise people will go with a bad heart. And we go and stand in front of the hospital for 5 minutes. We spend a lot of money to buy medicines. So my humble request to every one of you on this day, please find some time to nurture this body. Do some physical exercise. Practice it regularly and definitely your body will listen to you with this word. Thank each and every one of you for the patient's joy. I hope you will take up this small request from me for your own body, for your own goodness. required, but still we don't practice. We don't practice. That's all we know. This is real spirituality. Please overcome that barrier, do something, and let us all live healthy and prosper. Wish you all happy International Yoga Day. And thank you so much for hearing. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
Teachers, today we are gathered here to celebrate seventh International Day of Yoga. So on this occasion, I got opportunity to deliver a lot of thanks. First of all, I would like to thank our principal R.N. Sandeep Kumar for honoring this program with his inspirational thoughts and telling us importance of yoga. Thank you, sir. I would like to thank Mrs. Tamila Pavitran for organizing this program in a well manner. Again, I would like to thank Mrs. Kalyani Kalpana and Mr. Anand for making this program interesting by singing song. Last but not the least, I would like to thank all our beloved staff members for attending and making this program successful. Thank you. Do yoga, be safe and healthy.